Hello, this is Kate from DailyTarotGirl.com, and this is your weekly oracle card reading. So today I'm using the Goddess Guidance oracle cards. And before I get into the reading, I just want to announce that registration is now open for my new teleclass. It's a live teleclass, and it's called How to Give a Life Purpose Reading Using Angel Cards. So in the class, I will walk you through the process of giving yourself a life purpose reading using your angel or oracle cards. So that is on September 18th. I believe that's a Wednesday night at 6:30. And if you're interested, I've put the link to the page on my site in the description of this video. So you can just click on that link if you'd like more information or if you want to sign up. Okay, so I'll get into the reading. So we'll start with the first card, which represents Monday and Tuesday of the upcoming week. And we've got Bast, and she's all about being independent. And her message says, your independence is a foundation for your strength and success. So we're starting off the week strong. And I get the sense like many of us are going to be feeling very confident at the beginning of the week. We're going to be feeling very capable, and we're going to be able to really tap into our strengths and maximize our, you know, our skills and our talents, and really feel like we can do things on our own. So the beginning of the week isn't necessarily a time to, it's not necessarily a time to reach out to others or to ask for help. But it's not that you can't do those things, it's just that you probably won't feel the urge to do that. You're going to feel very strong in yourself, very independent. And one interesting thing about this is that other people who are feeling maybe a little bit weaker or are struggling are going to be drawn to you, because you do radiate this strength and independence. And in that sense, you might feel like you're attracting people who might need your time or your energy. So basically, it's up to you to decide, you know, how you're going to deal with that, and you know, how available you want to be to other people. Okay, so moving on into the middle of the week, Wednesday, Thursday, we've got Freya, and her card says bold. And it's interesting because she, I get such a similar feeling with Freya as I do with Bast. They're both very strong, you know, independent, bold cards. And the message on Freya's card says, unleash your adventurous side, take risks, and be daring. So the independence and strength that we feel in the beginning of the week is going to be carried through to the middle of the week, and it's going to allow you to feel just more, like the card says, more adventurous, more daring. You're going to be feel more willing to take risks than you normally would. And so you want to take advantage of this time, because often we feel almost hesitant to take risks, and we might think things through and have a hard time making a decision. But this week is all about making the decisions, taking the risks, doing things that might actually be out of our comfort zone normally, or things that might be kind of out of character for us. But in the end, they're going to enrich our lives and give us a much more satisfying experience. Okay, and moving to the end of the week. So this card represents Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We've got Isolde, Undying Love, and she's a nice, she really stands in contrast to the other two goddesses here. She's a little bit softer, and her message says, the love you have shared is eternal, regardless of the situation. And this card speaks about relationships and your relationship to others, particularly romantic partners, but also your relationship to yourself and your relationship to your life's work. So it could be your relationship to the things that you feel passionate about, whether they be people, places, or things. And the message I get with this card, she says, the love you've shared is eternal, regardless of the situation. And I'm getting a sense of past life issues coming into play here, whether that's through people or like I said, people, places, or things, I get the feeling that you'll be working through a lot of past life stuff. And not necessarily past life, but it could just be stuff from your past. So cycles that you've been repeating for a very long time, whether they be cycles that you've been repeating over many lifetimes or just this lifetime, you're gonna get the opportunity to recognize that. So that's going to come around again this weekend. And you'll have that opportunity to sort of notice the role you play in your normally unconscious patterns. And this isn't necessarily a bad thing. Like, it's not necessarily destructive patterns. This is just patterns that play out. And these could be positive things. They could be, you know, negative patterns. Actually, that's kind of irrelevant whether it's positive or negative. But what's important is that you will become conscious of the patterns and you'll see the role that you play. So then you can decide, you know, does this work for me? Do I want to keep playing this role? Do I want to step out of this role and, you know, do something different? You'll have that opportunity to see things with a much more clear gaze and clear focus than you have in the past. So I'm just going to take a little bit of a step back here with these cards and see if anything jumps out at me. And what I'm noticing is the body language of the goddesses in the cards. So the beginning of the week, Bast has her arms wide open. So I feel like this is the beginning of the week is the time to kind of approach things with open arms. So be open. Be open to life and kind of take on life with that sort of open-armed excitement or that open-armed energy where you're strong and you're ready to take things on. And then as we move to the middle of the week with Freya, she's got her arms kind of covering her body, but she's looking straight at us. And to me, this is saying as we move through the week, we tend to kind of shift from that kind of open, take on the world kind of energy to a more introverted energy, but we're more focused and we're still feeling strong, we're still feeling bold, but we're gathering our energy inward. So you might experience this as feeling like you don't necessarily want to be around people in the middle of the week. So the beginning of the week you may feel more extroverted, more social, and then in the middle of the week you're kind of having that urge to kind of retreat inside yourself. And then as we get to the weekend card is so much more, I get more of a spiritual sense with this card. There's like the halo of light around her and there's all the flowers and pretty things in this card and the rainbow colors. And I get the sense like the weekend is more of a spiritual time. The week is quite practical in terms of the kinds of things you're going to be doing and your headspace. It's all going to be very practical, material, down to earth. But when we get to the weekend, this is the time to get more into a spiritual kind of zone. I hope that makes sense. So I just want to wish you the best of luck this week. It looks like a really wonderful week coming up. And make sure that you take advantage of those independent, strong energies. And so enjoy your week and thank you so much for listening.